Why do you prefer Macrium Reflect over Windows' own built-in image program? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not signed up for my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing, visit newsletter.askleo.com and sign up today. Every week we'll get tips, tricks, answers to questions like this in your inbox. Here's the question. Is Macrium Reflect superior to the disk imaging utility included in Windows? And if so, in what regard? Yes, it is, in a lot of regards. Not the least of which is that Microsoft has actually said we should start using something else. Let me explain. Since Windows 10, if you look carefully for the backup and restore utility in Windows, you'll see that it actually has a parenthetical comment. It says, backup and restore, parentheses, Windows 7. Even though we're in Windows 10 and in Windows 11, this backup and restore utility is referred to specifically as the backup and restore utility from Windows 7. That is because Microsoft is no longer updating the backup and restore utility. In fact, they have stated that we should stop using it. Quote, the feature is also known as the backup and restore Windows 7 legacy control panel. For full disk backup solutions, look for a third-party product from another software vendor. In other words, they're saying, use something else. Don't use this. If you're trying to make image backups, use something else. Now, to be clear, Windows 7 backup is like the first of the Windows backup utilities to really meet what I would consider to be the bare minimum. What do I mean by the bare minimum? Well, full image backups that you can schedule to happen automatically. A controlled and obvious way of managing your disk space so that you know what you're getting. The ability to restore not only a full image, but to be able to extract individual files from an image, and some sense that the backups are reliable and will be there when you need them. Windows backup meets that just barely. All of those things are met, just not very well. My biggest complaint about the Windows 7 backup utility, to be honest, is that once you turn it loose, I have no idea what it's doing. There's no progress information, errors are horrible, there's very little flexibility about exactly how and where things get stored. It's just a frustrating experience. And if there weren't better alternatives, of course I'd be saying we should all be using it. But the bottom line is that there are much better alternatives. Now, you've mentioned Macrium Reflect. To me, that is one of the most robust and professional backup solutions you can have for the home. In fact, it is something that I believe in so strongly, I've actually created an online course, Saved Backing Up with Macrium Reflect 8, to help you understand, install, get your backups configured, understand how to restore, prepare for all of the inevitable failures that could come along when you're using your technology. To be clear, Macrium's not the only solution. There's a bunch of them out there. Another one that I often recommend is ESIS To-Do. The neat thing about ESIS To-Do is that they have a free version that is something that you absolutely can be using for these kinds of backups within the limits of the features that are available in that free version. But the bottom line is that there are so many better solutions to the Windows 7 backup program. There is simply no need, no reason to continue to use it, especially since Microsoft says you shouldn't. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/13826. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.